Yo, it's your boy RJ in the building, and today we getting aggressive with it. First, before we start the guide, I want to talk about next time when I stream, I will be doing a poll on the next character guide I should do. Don't get me wrong, I will cover these characters anyways, but I just thought, why not let the man them, yeah, guess what, one, you know what I'm saying? So out of the characters that it is from, we have Nagato, the second Mizukage, Temari's fine self, and then. So don't miss out, follow me on Twitch at RJXHunters, link is in the description, don't miss out. Now without further ado, let's get into the character guide. And again, before we go back, and I know I said further ado, but guess what, we're breaking the rules. Follow me on Twitch. If you're not following me, follow me. If you follow me, tell your friend, your friend's friend, your mom's friend, your mom's sister's friend, and follow RGS Hunters. Again, the link is in the description. Now fuck off. Yo, what is up? It's your boy RJ in the building, and today we are with the man, the myth, the legend, once again, Mr. Reanimation Hero, also known as Calmed Hero now. So would you like to introduce yourself?
Hello guys, name's Hero, Calmed Hero, Reanimation Hero, whatever you want to call me. And yeah, RJ invited me to do a video with him. Mm-hmm. Hope you guys enjoy.
Alright, cool. So obviously, as you know, this is a Teach Me series where I get higher level / pro level players or top level players to talk about a tech or character, and Mr. Hero is going to be doing older Shino. So obviously, now obviously from when you saw the interview video, you can see what he's learned as being a very knowledgeable player of the game as well. So without further ado, let's get into it. Alright, so as now that we're in here, what I first want to ask, what I start with as well, is what is like the overview of Shino? Meaning, like, if you had to give like a general description of Shino, what would you say, what kind of character would you say he's like?
Well, but Shino, he's different from other range types when I think about it, because he's basically all when I use him, mm-hmm. and how I find that he's best to be used is fighting up close.
Okay.
Many times, people use range characters for further ranges, but he is like medium to close range combat type of range character, and okay. he has a lot of potential overall for combo things and setups.
Yeah,
which is really the reason why I use him.
Yeah,
and he used to be way better, and is probably the best range character throughout all the Naruto games.
Yeah,
because his neutral game was easy to connect, but now mm-hmm. it's not that easy. This storm game, but there's ways around it, and he's still pretty damn good once you get used to him.
Yeah, I feel like obviously with the patches, he did get that nerf where obviously people kind of was questioning him, but I still think he's pretty strong, especially with his jutsu. I think his jutsu is pretty one of the best things about him as well. So, I mean, on the topic of that, what can you tell me about Shino's jutsu, like just as a whole? We'll start with his jutsu.
Basically, his jutsu has fantastic tracking, has a huge hitbox too. One mm-hmm. thing it does is it's one of the best air jutsus when you're using him as support, because I don't think he gets hit as much as other people when he's in the air, and his jutsu tracks really quickly and it could stop people attacking you from above. But when using it with setups, I find it's pretty good to like trap somebody into their guard because they know it's coming. But overall, yeah. Overall, I think it's pretty strong. It's not for zoning well. It's mostly for setups and trapping people in guards.
Yeah.
If you're trying to zone with Shino, it's not going to work out too well with that.
Okay, alright. So you're saying like his jutsu is good defensively and it's good for like guard pressure, like locking people down with someone. Not so much necessarily like zoning, yeah. For example, like Data's jutsu. Yeah. It's more just for setups and that kind of guard pressure.
Yeah, one example I like to use with Shino is when I knock someone onto the ground.
Yeah.
I immediately just run at them jutsu and switch and just hope to lock them in the guard.
Yeah, I do the same as well. Yeah. That's good for like stuff like after like his grab as well and stuff like that. I'm sure. Yeah. Yeah. Because yeah.
If you're up close to a wall and they're knocked towards a wall, mm-hmm. and you get that bounce, you can do it here too. Things up like that.
Yeah. Okay. So it's good for like wake up options, basically. Anytime you knock someone down, you can always use it to wake up. So they just wake up straight into the jutsu, or it's in their face, basically.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Cool.
Even if fucking like I don't know, maybe you just use a juice up above and it slowly just travels and it gives you time to kind of think about the next option of what you're going to do. But the only thing about it is it takes a while to come out.
Yeah,
it's easily punishable if the opponent sees it coming. But it has good tracking. It's very slow. The only thing is it's easily punished and it doesn't last very long.
Okay, I mean, I think it's pretty decent to hide behind. Like, if you was to do something like this, and you hide behind it, you can, like, get chakra, you can set up wherever you want to set up, and so I think it's probably good for, like, stuff like that as well. Like, you know, like, defensive play, I think it's pretty good for that, I would say. Yeah. Okay.
I like comparing it to Madara's, past Madara's, just base jutsu, how it travels super slowly, and things like that, and it covers you. But it doesn't last so long as this jutsu, which is sad. Would make him more OP if it lasted longer. But just the fact that it hits somebody while they're on the ground, and it tracks like crazy, like 360 degrees and stuff like that, which makes it really, really nice.
Okay, all right, cool. So. What we discovered of Hoshino's jutsu based off your description, big hitbox, really good defensive jutsu, like to be in the air as well, because you figure that he doesn't really get hit out the air as much. It's grounded as well, good for wake up options as well. It's good for guard pressure, like for example, how I do it with guard pressure, I'll use Utakata as example, just hold block. How I usually do it for guard pressure is like, I'll like do cut him and I'll kind of like do that right in their face, stuff like that. So it's really good for guard pressure as it hits multiple times. So it's pretty solid. It basically is just a pretty solid setup in the way kind of jutsu is what I'm hearing. You want to use it to be an annoyance, not necessarily to zone. All right, cool. So moving on from that, what can you tell me about his circle combos then?
His circle combos, basically there's 3 hits for his neutral, 2 hits for his... for his air combo. And one good thing about his neutral combos is they could connect to his square combos as long as you cast quickly and just continue on with it.
Okay.
It really sets him apart from other ranged characters, in my opinion. Because in previous Storm games, you would be able to hit once and transfer into a square combo.
Yeah.
But now, there's more steps, but his circle combo is really good. His first hit is surprisingly really, really, his hitbox is really big, surprisingly. And his air combo is, it's quick to get somebody off of you. And, say for example, you have Sarada, you can tilt and switch to Shino, and his first hit's super quick, so you can get a punish off that, which is really nice.
Okay. So abuse his first hit, basically, like you're saying. Abuse, like, get damage, get damage. Alright, there we go. So abuse his first hit, basically, is what you're saying, because it has a massive hitbox on his first hit. So you can you can really abuse his first hit for that, as well as obviously.
Well, I was gonna say if you get the first hit off or any of the hits off, if for the third hit, obviously, you can connect it to a square combo through a through an air dash.
Yeah.
Which really sets him apart from other ranged characters, in my opinion, why I have him on most of my main.
Yeah, I think you can do it from it, just a normal air dash as well, like this, I'm pretty sure, as well, no?
Yeah, just normal air dash.
Yeah.
Just dash at him and just hit him.
Because then, obviously, that will stop people, like, you know, trying to counter you or anything like that. So yeah. I think that's pretty good. I think that's pretty good for him to have, actually, because then that gives him, rather than going in with a circle combo, you can go in with a square combo, which we'll get into pretty much after. Okay, so again, so based off his combos, his first hit, abuse his first hit, massive hitbox on his first hit as well. Would you say that he has good guard pressure, like, regarding his combos, or like?
No, that's one thing, that his guard pressure is not that good, but overall you could connect to Jutsu in that, which is a good guard pressure. So if you're like attacking like that, it's not really good, but you could like connect it to a Jutsu and things like that to make it decent.
Okay.
Because your circle combo is mainly just to pin somebody down and get them trapped.
Yeah.
When you're up close, that's why I say he's more of a mid-range to close combat type of range character, even though it kind of contradicts itself, but he's mainly used for that that area.
Okay. All right. So he's more of like I said, he's more lockdown character. So he locks down for your opponent. I know that in his guard pressure that you can, if you block the first hit, I think you can counter the second hit. I don't know if they took that out or not, but I think you can. Hey, do it again. Yeah, there you go.
Ooh, yeah. So, that's why I like doing the first hit instead, then like dashing.
Yeah. Something. I mean, that's a mix up in itself, because if you do the first hit and then just do this.
Yeah.
Then it's like,
one of the things that makes Bonzo really good too, because there's a counter and there's like third hit or something like that.
Yeah.
You can mix people up with it, which is really, really nice.
Yeah.
That's why I usually just hit once and continue guard pressure. And if they're blocking, I'll just dash, which
Jutsu,
buffer my Jutsu and things like that.
Okay. So, all right, cool. So, like I said, so play off of his first hit. That's what I'm getting. Play off of that first hit, basically. that's where the magic happens regarding his combos. Mm-hmm. Okay.
If the first hit, if it connects, you could continue it with a square combo by dashing into him, like canceling the hit, dashing. And if it doesn't hit, you could just mix them up, depending on what options you want to use, Jutsu switch or whatever. And his air combo is pretty well, pretty nice. Like you could switch like for Sarda, for example, just switch and start mashing.
Yeah.
So it's pretty well, pretty decent. His circle combos, most ranged characters' circle combos are pretty bad.
Yeah.
And I really like, if I were to rank them, in my opinion, I do not like Mizukage's, Deidara's combos at all. I don't mind Utagata's. I think his are pretty nice too.
You don't like Deidara's combos?
His neutral combo, his last couple hits is really good.
Yeah.
That's what I like about Utagata. And Shino's, in my opinion, is one of the best, because you can connect it off so many things if it hits.
Okay. That's interesting, actually.
One thing about Shino's too is his air combo is makes the character fly forward, so there's a chance for strike back opportunity and support.
Yeah, like it's a strike, it's quick as well, it doesn't take long, it's literally just two hits and then boom, strike back. So okay, all right, so now best, basically what we talked about, Jutsu, his combos. Let's just get into the meat of the character then and talk about his bugs now. So this is where, obviously, you know, most of the character is, he's a ranged character, so he has, this is where his up, down and neutral combos are. So anything to do with the bugs, even his air bugs as well, what can you tell me about him?
The thing about his bugs is, when it comes to his bugs, this is regular shuriken, his Chaka shuriken, I think it's Shocker Shuriken. It's pretty underrated. Actually, it not a lot of people use it when they use Shino. They just use it for guard pressure. But even just like running up to somebody and just doing that is enough to throw them off balance. And yeah. One big thing about Shino that I see a lot of people do is use a neutral combo a lot. In previous games, it used to be better, but it's not as good now. I'd say it'd be only. You'd use it only for
Tracking like the neutral maybe.
Away. If they're like further distance away, like this distance, like super range, the only time I think it should be used. But if you're in medium and close range, a down combo, an up combo is really good. Because the down combo, it creates a wall, and if someone dubs his last hit for his bugs with his down combo, he could get hit twice and just waste a sub completely. And they both have follow potential because they both stun for a really long time.
Okay.
Yeah, because up combo combo is I think it's his fourth bug. It creates an infinite combo, which is really nice, and you could really just follow up with many things. Like it locks so long, you take a pill or a tag and things like that.
Yeah.
And honestly, I think out of all the combos I use, if in close range, if someone's blocking and they're close range, the down combo is the way to go right here because it pushes them away. Also, there's not much openings where you could like switch dash if somebody were to try to get out of the up combo.
Yeah.
Using like guard, you could like, there's many options and there's an opening for with the up combo. But if somebody stops the fourth. On the fourth hit of the up combo, hold on. Someone stops on the fourth. Damn, I can't stop it. Like it's a little bit too delayed, but
there is a delay.
You can really get out of it. You really get out of it easily if you're looking for the up combo. But doing the down combo, since it comes out so fast and it travels like that, it's really well. Really
nice.
And it has a huge hitbox for the last hit.
Yeah, definitely. So it's like on guard, like. It has multiple hits in it. I think the up combo is best used if you were to layer it with another character. So let's say you had a Shizui, then you'd obviously do the up combo with Shizui just because the last hit of his up combo does so much guard pressure. I would say maybe that's like the only time. I'm guessing if you're doing the machine on itself, then obviously you want a down combo because obviously it tracks, has the pushback as well. And if they do sub for any reason, then the second hit can always hit him. So, as a summary of what you said, he has an infinite in his fourth hit. Oops. I know he has one in his third hit as well, but a fourth hit is a bigger stun, so you can do more compared to his third one.
Well, one good thing about the one thing that I think people have to watch out for is when they're using Shino is his up combo and his down combo, they don't turn around hit. But his regular combo, like say for example if you were right behind me, his regular three hits will follow him from behind, which is really nice. And say for example if you're on the ground and stuff behind me, the bugs will travel behind me and they'll still stun you long enough because the third hit will stun somebody long enough
for you to continue again.
The combo.
Yeah. So it has the first three hits have 360 tracking basically, is what you're saying.
Yeah.
Okay.
And what if this is a scenario you're probably gonna find yourself in a lot with Shino, is when somebody's in the air, and they're like vulnerable, like you know you could hit them. There's 100% chance guaranteed. There's about you want the opponent to be near the ground and landing in order to land the up combo, because they could block the regular but just jump and don't hold block.
Okay. Cool.
Okay. Like just block, be like that.
Yeah.
There's like moments where they could block instead, but if they're closer to the ground, I don't even think I got it there. Okay, well it's fine. If they're closer to the ground, there's like no opportunity to block.
Yeah, I'm holding block the whole time.
Yeah, and if you're like super high in the air, it's a lot harder. They have opportunity to block.
Oh, that one kind of got manipulating me there. There you go.
It didn't come out there because their delay between the thing, but
yeah, it's just
it's pretty much guaranteed that they're gonna get the block off if you try to do the up combo from higher areas.
Yeah,
but see right there, there's a 360 tracking option right there.
Yeah, and the forfeit didn't track at all, so yeah. That's where it is.
Yeah, and so if you find yourself in that position, just get ready to switch after your third hit and follow up with somebody else, because it's not gonna land whatsoever. You might as well get some damage in somehow. I don't know how.
So you're saying if they're too high, for example, let's say, I don't know, they have a strike back or something. If they're too high, then you want to do three bugs, and then you want to capitalize on someone else and then go in. Whereas if they're a bit too low, say if they're low down to the floor and they're kind of like floating a little bit, then you can get the fourth hit on the up combo to get that stun.
Yep.
And then it can either be infinite or you can switch, anything.
There's like so many more options after that.
Okay. So you want to basically, if you are juggling someone, you would preferably want them close to the ground. So let's say, for example, your team, you do like a pain juggle, yeah? So you're pain, you do like a pain juggle. You can literally just do this support combo, switch into Shino, and I'll be low down enough for you to do the up combo, and it'd be okay, and then you can get a whole bunch of setups.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. So as I was saying, obviously, because these are ranged characters, the bugs is where the meat of it is. So to recap all of it, in terms of guard pressure, the down combo is probably a way to go, as well as, you know, baiting out subs, because obviously if they sub the last hit, it'll hit them again straight to the floor, or it can make them sub again, so they get two subs out of it, which is pretty good. The up combo is good for guard pressure, but it's best used with a jutsu. So like the up combo with a jutsu, just because it's easier to get out of as well, like you said. The neutral combo is probably his weakest combo in this game, but you said again at maybe like around here.
Yeah, maybe at a further range.
Yeah, you can use it because it has pretty, you know, there's times where if they ninja move it to the side, then it can track quite a bit. You're saying stuff like that. What else did you say?
Yeah, you definitely do not want to rely on it in this close range. Because there's a chance they could block it. Like in that, I think it was a 6 hit there. There's a chance to block it.
Yeah. Okay. So you want to avoid using this neutral combo, basically. Is that up and is down combo is where it's at, basically.
Yeah. It's only okay to use a neutral if you're like super far away, because it tracks well.
And, yeah.
Last bugs, like, it knocks somebody away further away. It's really nice.
Okay.
And his chakra shuriken, I think they're really good.
I think his chakra shuriken tracks more than that neutral combo. Like this, I think just using this in the neutral, just in itself, like look at the tracking. I think that's where.
Yeah, the only reason why I'd say that, probably don't want to just using this for like
open his chakra,
because you need the dash in order to continue combos like that. But one thing I see a lot of people not using with Shino is his air combo. Because I'm going to be honest, it's pretty trash. It's just one hit. It would have been better if there was, like, I don't know, maybe something, maybe if it stunned longer for the first hit, but that would be pretty OP, just being once hit, it stuns long.
I mean, how I tend to use the air combo is I will switch on that hit.
Yeah.
That's how I use it.
It's really good if you have the switch ready. I sometimes just do that.
Damn.
I'll catch people like that.
All right. I did not see that coming. Damn.
That's what I use with bombs. Like, I stole this team from Playco. Guard can pretty much follow anything that happens. Like this first hit, and with Pain, also really quick doing that as well.
Okay.
And his air combo really finds stuff like that.
So okay.
Pretty nice.
I was gonna say the most that I use this for is like if I know someone's gonna be aggressive, I'll do this switch, and then if they dash, they'll clash into me, and then the second hit will hit them away to get the strike back. But you came with some next Sarada Shino tilt combo, like I was not ready. there you go, Shino Sarada. That's a match. That's the thing.
I guess you could actually follow it up with another switch after that. Like as you said, you like to switch after that.
Yeah.
You could just use Sarada, switch, use Shino's air combo, and switch to Pain afterwards, which is pretty nice.
Yeah. Give me a that is idea. Pretty nice. That is pretty good, stole, yeah.
I stole this team from Pleiko. The only person I switched out was Sasuke, which, you know, that's pretty much it.
Oh, yeah, yeah, because he does use that team. Sarada, Pain, and Sasuke. I think he does put Madara in it sometimes as well. But for real, that Sarada and Shino, I like that. Because I don't know if you know me as a player, but I know I like all the range characters, so I'm going to have to finesse that one.
Yeah, because Sarada really walks him down. Like, say, for example, if that shuriken hits, follow up with Shino's infinite and things like that.
Okay, yeah, I might have to. I'm definitely gonna be looking into that. I'm not gonna lie to you, I'm gonna be honest. Yeah. That's good.
One thing I think you'd have to, with using Shino, there's a lot of opportunity for ultimate cancels, right? Like a UJ cancel off. The way you want to look for it is with his down combo, because his last hit, it's more damage than his regular one like that. It's a little bit, but. It's a little bit, but there's a. There's a chance, what's that called? There's a chance of, what was I gonna say? Is it better to use a down comp for ultimate cancel? You can use both of them, and honestly, you shouldn't write off the combos.
Yeah.
It's just, the down one does more damage in my.
It's just basically it's really max close. Damage, basically. So when you're going for max damage, you want to use it. I'll say the only time to use dark combo is like if you're like here. Let's say you clip someone from real far here, then you could probably do it. But if you're up close, then obviously you go for a down combo and then do your thing.
Yeah, because the down combo doesn't work from this distance. In that way, or in this like distance, you want to use the up combo.
Yeah.
And in my opinion, to get tagged off more consistently, you want to use. You want to use up combo, then you can get two things off, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, true. Max damage. If you've got someone that knows subs, you just come in, boom, boom, tag, and then you're good to go. So, yeah. That's like max damage. Okay.
Yeah.
So, yeah, so Sheena's got a lot. Basically, Sheena's really good at setting people up, but he's also, you can rock it in himself as well. Which is pretty good. Okay. All right, so is that anything covered from his bugs that you can tell me about regarding, or is there anything more?
Honestly, Shino has a lot of things that you could probably what's the right word for it? There's like a lot of things you can make up on the fly.
Yeah.
With him.
So it's more like you just gotta lap his options.
Yeah, his first three hits, like they fly behind him. Is really nice, and if they're on the ground, his third hit stuns them long enough for you could follow up on it.
Yeah.
And basically, you want to use a down combo and up combo as they both have different properties, but they still have the long stun and they're guaranteed once they land.
Yeah.
And they're pretty nice from there.
Okay.
I don't know where this classifies at, but his tilt, and I don't know if it's bugs or is a circle combo. I'm just gonna assume it's a circle combo. But one good property about his tilt is it has a Storm 3 property that Storm 3 Kakashi has. Is if he air tilt with him, he'll continue to his regular neutral combo instead of continuing the whole tilt. Mm-hmm. So if you could get somebody with the air tilt, look, just jump up in the air and air tilt with him and mash circle.
Okay. Oops. I guess I messed up there. I messed up there too. It's a bit like you saw them. I get it.
I pressed square, which is kind of weird.
So I was late on that, I feel like. Alright, hold on. Oh my god. Alright, hold up. It's because of the delay, yeah. Alright, one more. Alright, let me get you then.
Okay. Yeah, this is really hard with
the link. It's hard, actually. Okay, let me use data.
Oh, it is. Yeah, right there, see?
Yeah, I just seen it. Yeah.
Neutral combo. Whoa. Okay. Yeah, it's really. But if you're not on leg and you air tilt properly, it'll continue with neutral combo, which is really nice.
Okay.
Is this kind of hard in leg right now?
There is. There is. We got there in the end.
Yeah.
Okay, I did not know that either.
Yeah, and his tilt, it It hits multiple times and stuns them, so if it hits, you're pretty much set for a follow-up, honestly. Okay.
Would you say...
And if you air tilt and it hits, you could follow up afterwards and dash out of it, or you could just switch. Because his tilt stuns long enough where you could get an ultimate off. Like, you could just sub this, but...
Oops, I was mashing it as well. Alright.
Yeah, it's delayed. But it stuns enough where you could, just continue with the ultimate enough. Afterwards.
Yeah. Would you say, I was gonna say, you see with that air tilt, he goes, does it reset him into neutral? So, like, could he, like, air tilt and then land and then throw bugs, or can you only press circle after it?
I'm not sure. I usually just mash circle, hit with the first hit, and dash afterwards, depending on how they get hit in that.
Okay.
You can try it right now if you
can. Okay, I'll try it. Hold on. I'm gonna get this one day. Hold on.
I'm gonna dash at you instead because it's a lot easier to time.
Okay. I'm gonna try and like preempt it. Alright. I have to do it early. I'm trying to do it early. Nah, hold on. Let me check. Oh my god, it's 30. Nah, you can't. I was literally mashing square there.
he has a Storm 3 Kakashi property. If you use Storm 3 Kakashi, his first hit of his tilt will come out, and it'll reset him to the neutral combo or just any combo.
Okay.
And also has that property. So if you get an air tilt off, and they start getting stunned, you could switch. You could immediately reset it to mash with the first hit, which is really nice.
Yeah, okay. Bro, I didn't know that either. See, every time I do these videos, I learn something new. But yeah, no, I didn't know that either. Yeah, the fact that I didn't even notice that. So yeah, that's good. That's a good paying attention to detail if someone likes to dash you, and especially because you said the first hit has a massive hitbox on it, innit? So
yeah,
that might happen. They might dash next, you know, boom, you get knee to the face.
Yeah, I don't know how much frames a frame Gino's hit comes out. I know it's pretty fast. You can probably ask Playco on what frame it comes out, but if it has a larger hitbox, and if you could catch somebody dashing at you and you hit them like that, it's pretty good.
Yeah.
And it's honestly a good follow up because if you hit somebody, you could just continue on with the regular things.
Okay.
And lastly, if you're not confident you'll get this jutsu off, this ultimate off, do not do this. Look how long I'm stunned for.
Look how long he's there. Bro, it takes him a year to do the jutsu, then another year to recover from doing the ultimate jutsu. He's there for so long.
Hold block. Even if you block it, I'm still in the thing. So that's one thing you have to avoid. That's why he has so many setups with his other combos, where you could just like do a down combo switch, or just do this and switch, because it's so much better than doing his own regular, own regular thing. That's why I say, like, say for example, if I use pain, I tilt in it and you're in the air and you're bouncing, wait for them to come down, then do the air combo. Then you'll have chance to switch and get them off with one of those.
Okay.
One of those ultimate.
Alright then. So, I think we covered everything apart from Sheena's Awakening, I'm pretty sure. We covered his tilt, his jutsu, his combos, his normal combos. I think the only thing we have left to cover is his Awakening.
Alright.
So what can you tell me about his Awakening as soon as I get you there? There we go. What can you tell me about
his Awakening? His L1, R1, they travel pretty... But not L1, R1, my bad. I was thinking about Revolution. His Awakening actions, they track pretty well, and they also stun for a long time. So you can get somebody like that, and they do massive damage, and they take down Chakra. Which is really good if you're kind of punish somebody, and you can dash out of it, continue it like that.
Yeah.
So, but he's not going to be good for, he's not going to be, like, a super game changer unless you're punishing somebody. So otherwise, you're not going to be punishing them, like, consistently.
I know that it becomes an infinite as well.
Yeah.
Literally. So you're just constantly just depleting their chakra while depleting their health as well.
Yeah.
How exactly. I tend to use it. Sure, you go on.
I'm pretty sure with every other, like, I was tilt, his circle, like, you cancel the awakened action with everything. And it tracks like crazy, like right there. I was past it with any regular jutsu who wouldn't turn around, but that one turned around.
Yeah.
And so it's literally it's worth it if you're confident you could catch somebody and punish them.
Yeah.
Because his bugs don't get any special property, they're probably the same as ever. His dash is it's the awakening nerf. I mean, not nerf, buff as always.
Yeah.
His priority and things like that.
Okay.
Overall, I think his awakening is pretty good if you get the awakening actions off. Otherwise, it's just the same old Shino.
Yeah, I mean, his awakening actions are really good. Like I said, it's just if you trust yourself to get it, basically.
Yeah. Like, literally. I'm pretty sure in previous games, just see if you hold block. See if it's still... Yeah, after I hit you.
Okay.
Yeah, see, in previous games, that used to work, but it doesn't. So try to avoid that and just hit him, then continue on with it.
Yeah.
Because otherwise it's, you know, not going to connect. Okay. If you really just want to punish Shino, or punish with Shino as soon as you get an awakening. Because he's not going to be able to, like, you're going to be doing what Shino does in, like, a regular match. Like, setting you up, fighting in mid-range, slash close-range combat. Things like that. And if your team's built properly, where you could where you could like continue stuff like that.
He's
gonna shine.
Okay.
One big thing I see a lot of people do with Shino though is as soon as like just dash at me. Like they'll try to do that, but that's not gonna work with because you could like immediately block after like it. Like you could what the.
It's the lag, probably.
Yeah, you could immediately block and get punished severely by just doing that. So you really want to just like fight in close range. Like you could probably if you dash me, you could like probably
Oops, I dashed.
You could probably jutsu then like continue something on, but otherwise not gonna do much if you just try to get square combos off like right away. Like you have to set it up where you're in super close range or like in super close mid range where it's guaranteed. Like you can't bet on his bugs in mid range combat if it's not guaranteed. But there's chance of locking people in if they're just gonna guard, you know. After they're done guarding you can maybe switch dash and his bugs will still be coming out. Where you could and you want from there. So there's really good guard pressure, but it's not going to guarantee any follow up from it.
Okay.
And there's one thing. I see a lot of Datara users. Mm-hmm. You have Datara. His things come out like super quick. Like say for example, just switch to Datara, and I'll dash you and just sub in or mashing where. Okay. Like it comes out quicker and like with Shino, you could probably sidestep with it afterwards, but with him, you could like immediately continue on, and it comes super quick. And one good thing about both Shino and Datara is Datara's air combo is superior, and but they're both last hits. It sends the opponent flying. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, that last hit sends them flying. This last hit sends them flying.
Yeah, I mean, same with Utagata, really, but this is a bit different. Yeah. But that is bubbles sending you flying too. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because one thing about both of them is like, Shino's like in the middle of both of them. Takeda has a bunch of bubbles coming out, but they're like super slow, but they can lock you in and do, and they have a lot of follow up potential. Datara has come out super quick. There's not a lot of his clay coming out, but it's super quick and it's. Could zone people out from further distances, and Shino's like right in the middle. He's mid range slash close combat, where you could go where you could follow, where you could like how could I say this? He's basically just in the middle of both of the range characters.
Yeah.
the comparing basically both their neutral square combos. Like Gator, I'm pretty sure some people try to use his air combo infinite, but it's not guaranteed sometimes. And but Shino is like the only character, other than like some instances with other characters, where he has a true infinite, where he can just keep going like that. Like his other range characters, like sometimes their infinites work. Hakata has like a lot of button locks, which is really nice about him. But other characters, they don't really have the things that Shino has.
Yeah.
But they all have their own perks. Like Deidara, he has a lot of zoning potential. Utakata has his bubbles, has a lot of follow-up options with his bubbles, because they travel far, they last long, they can lock you in.
Yeah.
And I think Deidara really shines with his square combos rather than circle combos. And Utakata, his circle combos are really nice. Square combos are really good close range. And I think Shino stands in the middle of them, where his circle is pretty nice, and the square combos are really good in mid-range and close-range combat. So he's basically right in the middle of both of them.
He's kind of like an all-rounder. That's how I kind of see Shino. He's kind of like...
Yeah.
He can fight you with his circle combos, but he can also use his... You know, he can also, like, utilize his bugs to you as well.
Yeah. And, like, Gator's tilt is, like, superior when switching.
Yeah.
Like, it's really good because his again, stupid things like track like crazy, like those little spider thing. And Utakata's, he just goes in a bubble. That's it, pretty much.
Yeah. But,
it's decent. It's like not the best tilt.
It has a lot of tracking in it, and obviously you can cancel it.
Yeah, it has a lot of tracking. It covers them. But it's not the best tilt like Deidara's, where everybody uses it consistently, and it's like it's pretty nice. And Shino really is like in the middle of both of them still in that regard, because it doesn't come out, but it has potential to lock somebody down. And even if you're doing an air tilt, you can switch it.
Yeah.
You can switch your melee from it.
So you can still set it out and then go to someone else as well as having the bugs out, basically.
Yeah, he's basically an all-arounder, you know. Air is good for zoning long range, you know, just being annoying. Talk at a close range. There's a lot of follow-up potential, things like that. And Shino's just right in the middle, where he's all around her. Like that.
Okay.
So it really depends on your playstyle, how you want to play. Like, in my opinion, or in my playstyle, I like Shino. I like close-range combat, you know. I like fighting up close, using things like the combo buffer and things like that. I don't really use a lot of jutsu buffers like that.
Yeah.
I still use them, but I don't rely on them as much.
Yeah.
And it's just really how your play style of how you want to play. Because Shino is not a good zoning character, but he has a lot of punish game with his bugs.
Yeah, because obviously he has that range, so he can if he can punish you from like here.
Yeah, like say for example, even if I'm like from this range and I somehow get into bugs, not gonna matter because it's still gonna follow up.
Yeah,
like it's just a matter of how much. It's just a matter of how you punish him, I guess. Because if you could catch somebody from over here with the up combo, yeah, good. That's great, honestly. It's still going to work 100% of the time.
But
he's mostly used from mid-range, super close-range combat.
Okay. So, yeah, so that's pretty informative, to be fair, on Shino. The fact that, like I said, bugs, so much tech over it, so much stuff to go over it as well. Combos are strong. He's basically, like I said, he's just strong. Tilt's decent, jutsu's strong. Awakening, again, if you can lock someone down, it's really good. If you can catch someone with no subs, it's really good. You're putting their health and their mana. Like I said, once you get used to Shino, you kind of can't go wrong. Even though he's what I would say an A tier character, in my opinion, he's if used right, he can fight anyone, I feel like, personally.
Yeah.
So,
and if you can create a team it works well with Shino, like he will really shine with that. Like this team I have right now, I'm really liking it. Probably gonna be my main team that I use with him.
Yeah.
And just like I was pretty with that starter tilt, you know, things like that.
Yeah.
Pretty nice.
Yeah, it's pretty nice. I did really like that.
Example, if Sarda's ult hits, you could like follow up with a lot of things. But if Sarda uses tilt close range, it's better to use his circle combo. like things like that you need to find with certain different teams. Honestly, he'll shine a lot more once you use him and try him out. Like that.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Well, my final question to you then is, if somehow CC2 said to you, you can buff or nerf or change one thing about Sheena, like just one thing, only one thing, then what would you do? What would that be?
I'd bring his Storm 3 tilt back.
Okay.
Because his Storm 3 tilt, his tilt came out like basically frame 1, maybe like frame 2, who knows. And when somebody is comboing you, just comboing you, one of the, I don't know which one.
This one.
You right there, you'd be punished in Storm 3 immediately, because it comes out super quick.
Yeah.
And with his Storm 3 tilt, you'd immediately press square after it was hit.
Yeah.
That's probably what I'd bring back, honestly. Because his tilt was one of his best weapons in the older games. But now it's kind of like a side thing, where if it comes out and it works, it's fantastic, but it's hard to get out sometimes.
Okay. So you basically just speed up his tilt like how it was before, basically.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. That's good to know then.
I mean, I could say I want his old neutral damage back for his neutral combo, because it pretty much did the same amount of damage as a regular character's combo, but just in 3 hits.
Yeah.
That would probably be overdoing it. So
yeah.
I think, but the tilt would probably like improve his character by a lot more after that.
Yeah, he'd have good ways to get out of pressure, because you could like the fact that you can tilt and then just switch. Like if you could do that in a combo, then that's pretty much a whole counter attack that you have. Like okay.
That's exactly what.
Basically.
Because if Shino's getting guard pressure, there's not really much you could do. Maybe like Chakra Shuriken, or if you somehow have time to get the tilt up. But yeah, so basically all of his follow-up potential should be in like mid-range.
Yeah.
Or all of his, the way you want to fight with him is basically mid-range, close-range combat. There's not much after. Not much after that. That pretty much went over what I know about the character in all the years.
Alright. Well, Hero, thank you for coming on the Teach Me series then. You've definitely, like I said, opened my eyes to a lot of other stuff. Me playing Sheena myself, I'm definitely going to watch this back as well. See what I can grasp from it. See if there's anything I can remember as well. So again, thank you for coming by. Be sure to subscribe to Hero on YouTube. Do you have a Twitch as well? I'm not sure if you have a Twitch or not.
I do, I just don't stream often.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, still follow him on Twitch. Maybe one day he'll stream. Still follow him on Twitch, subscribe to him on YouTube, follow him on Twitter. I'll be sure to put his links to his socials in the description. So be sure to check him out. I'm sure he's going to be showing off that Sheena in tournaments and clan battles anytime soon, so keep an eye out for that. So without further ado, I bid you farewell. Peace, sayonara, and adios.